Hey there, how are you doing? This is Kali from TechFanciers. So in previous video, we have seen unlocking bootloader, recovery, this thing, that thing. Now we will do some fun stuff like how to install the Google Cam. It is simple because the device already supports the camera to API. You can directly go ahead and install. But here we will try to find the some good GCAM and the XML file for our GCAM. So you know the GCAM, it is an APK file ported from the Pixel devices, which will have some different configuration. So which we can install it, and it will take multiple picture and combine it, and it will give the good results. And the XML file, some of you already know, some of you who don't know, I'm just explaining. XML file is a descriptive file with contains the metadata and the configuration of the photos and videos that we are going to take, and how the it will tell the GCAM that how the photo has to be handled, how the resource has to be handled. So those kind of things it will have. So we will be, once we have the GCAM and the specific XML file for that specific device or specific need, we will have to achieve some good photos and things. So for example, if you want to take a portrait charts and these things, there are different XMLs, and if you want to take videos, there are different XML, night mode, there are different XML files. So we can use multiple XML files and to do multiple things. So there is no better one in my opinion. So as you can see in my screen, I am currently in the Redmi Note 10 Pro and Max photography community. So I will leave the link to this community in the description. Here there are some 25,000 photos are there. Some of them are person's picture, which I don't want to show. See here, you can see how it and all took. See the ant. So these and all really looking good. It is all because of this AI Snapdragon 732, because I believe the Pixel 5A or 4A using that kind of 7 series processor, I think. Maybe 730 or something, exactly the same. So due to that reason, we are getting this good shots with this camera. This is also one of the reason for me buying Redmi Note 11. So here this guy used different things, I believe. So here using SD cam 32.9 XML HDR plus main. So here also you can find the color signs, and whichever feels good for you, you can use it. But here what I'm going to do is, as soon as you get into this communities, first thing you need to do is you need to check the notes. So here we have ANX camera. ANX camera is nothing but the MIUI camera, but for AOSP based ROMs. So once we get into the Android 12 or 13 custom ROMs, we will try these things in this one. So here we have the best. So this guy will definitely not going to tell what is best, because there isn't anything called best. So there is no best camera. Different configuration will give different things, whichever I have explained you, I have already read it, so that's why I'm telling. So we have the GCAM. So I can use the control shift this one and the GCAM. So we have BSG, Nikita, Burial, Urani, Pixel Cam FE, this one is Tiger Camera, I think TR Camera, Shamimin, LMC, MTSL. So the one which I was earlier using in my Lite L1 and MA2, it's a Nikita Cam. So here also I'm trying to go with the Nikita one. So I'll just download the Nikita. It is not my recommendation. You just go through with the different ones and you try it. I will just download, I can just give old one, but yeah, I will just download the latest one. Here I have, I need to go to the archive, this one, Pro. Okay, here I have this Nikita cam. So this one I will install and I'll check it. Next thing that I'm going to do is, in this Telegram group, here you can see the pinned comments. This one is for Redmi Note 10 Pro Max. It is July 23. So after that, they didn't do anything, I believe. So here they have the sample footages. This also deleted. Okay, so whichever is the recent one, I will use it. So this one I will download. And here also we have the XML file. But this is for Pro Max, so what I can do for Pro? So for that reason, here we have another note called, where is my notes command? Yeah, here we have the notes called XML. So I can type hash XML. So they have the new this one in this XML. So GCAM link is here and this is here. Some samples. So this is also cool stuff. Pixel 6a and the library GCAM and the group link. And yeah, I will use the Prashant one. Who is Prashant? This account was hidden. Okay, nobody is going to do it, that one. So library, here we have GCAM. So here we have the GCAM. So this one I will just download it, and once I download it, I will save this one also in my save as. I will save this one also in the same folder, archive one. So this one is a different one. It is LMC camera by Prashant. So I'll just keep this one. So keeping it in a single folder will help you, because you want to use the same camera with the same configuration or something. So yeah, how I can go back, I don't know. So I will just open this one again. Here I have this one, what is library. So this one also, it's not required, I think. So okay, we need a library also in this one. So we have two libraries, GCAM startup darker and GCAM lighter. So both I will download, and we will keep that also in the same folder. This and all, lot of critical stuffs are there which I am not much knowledgeable on that one. So you may ask, if you are not knowledgeable, why you have to watch this video? Sorry, but this is the thing. GCAM, so where is this XML file? Here we have the XML. So it is from 6A, so save as. And that also I will keep it inside the this one. So finally we have this Nikita cam and the this one both. This both, now I will copy to my laptop, sorry, my mobile, and we'll continue the stuff. So here I will just connect the device and go to and data transfer. So now in my laptop, this entire GCAM folder I will paste to my internal storage, and we have the GCAM. So first I will try the Prashant's one. I will try only Prashant's one. Why we need to try everything? You also have the device, right? You try it. So it is dangerous. Yeah, we'll play with the danger stuff only every time. And okay, Insta. So also in the meantime, in my laptop, I'll open this one. So put the lib into LMC 8.1. So now while using the app, hello, done, top shot, okay, done. So almost this one looks good. Is it actually switching the camera? No, it is not switching the camera. It is just digital zoom or something. So HDR plus, and damn, these are actually looking good in the initial itself. So I will just now close this one and go to this folder, and here I have a GCAM. So no, and so I'll just copy this one. Okay, I'll just copy, and I'll go to internal storage, and the folder name should be LMC, but this LMC is not there. We can create a folder called LMC, or else what we can do is, in the camera we can double click here and it will automatically tell us configuration is not found. So that time if you open means LMC already will be there now. So I can open this folder now. Here we have the libs. I can open this and paste it. Okay. So this is one of the method that you can use. And now I need to paste the XML file. So here I have the XML file. I believe I can do both the libraries in the same time. So not here. And what is the folder name? It should be inside main storage. Okay, in the same folder itself we need to copy the XML. So yeah, both we have done now, and I now can open the Google Cam. And here if I click double time, it is showing the XML file, which I can just directly import it. Okay, we have imported it. And we have, here we can use different camera. So Pixel also main camera, and micro camera, which is left right side one. So now the right side one is using again the main camera, and Pixel camera is same. So yeah, and wide angle is bottom. Bottom one is wide angle. So right side is what camera, even I don't know. So now wide angle, it's there. So now I'll go to Pixel and take on photo. Now it is taken, and I'll go to I believe the snap process is something is happening, so I can't directly switch between cameras, I think. So still it is in Pixel. Now I'll take to micro. So this is micro. I'll just take one close or very close or short. So this is actually good looking one, and now I'll use my main one. So again I am taking it, and now we will, okay, it won't work again, crashed. Okay, so here it is clearly showing process is going or not. I am just mental. Okay, so now here that loading part is happening, so we need to wait for some second. So this is a wide angle, this is a normal one, this is portrait, and this is a Pixel one. So this is Pixel colors one. Okay, so I actually like all the mods and the things, and slow motion is somewhat not working. Pro mode is enabled. Okay, so how I can use pro mode, I don't know. Okay, here we have LDR means I'll use in main camera. LDR, no idea. Okay, pro. Maybe LDR means lower dynamic range or something. Okay, Faika. Turn off Faika. So Faika is just a color mode, I think. So Faika, it's okay. And pro mode is enabled. So here we have all the options. We even can shoot it in RAW. I'll take also now selfie, as I'll take. It's looking beautiful. Okay, smooth on is turned on. So different type. Okay, all three sides I have taken. So here also it's in main camera. Wide angle, if I put, what will happen? Here we don't have the wide angle, of course. So now here it is some glitch. Okay, I will take one with the Pixel one. Pixel color, how it is there, we'll check it. I'll just put normal subtle one. Okay, so now we have taken selfie and other things, both are working fine. And portrait it's somewhat looking more white one. I also can use the beautification subtool is fine. Okay, so here you can see the cropping, which is actually great. The beauty mode is not that much working, to be honest. So yeah, that is fine. I think I don't want a beauty mode or something. So if we turn off the pro mode, means what will happen? So now I will go to video and we'll try video how it is working. So it is actually good in my opinion. So external microphone also you can enable it, which is really really good. 4K, can I shoot 4K 60fps? Okay, yeah, I can't shoot the 4K 60fps. Yeah, I can't shoot it, so I'll just set it to 30 and now take it. Okay, 4K 30 is working fine, but it has little bit some sort of jittering effect, but that is fine. But this is fine actually for a GCAM, it is more than enough for me. And for 60, 1080 60. NHD60 is actually having the stabilization also. So here we have different mode of stabilization, and if it is locked means it will give a lot of crop, but the thing will be really really good, but I'm not going to use it because these all are software stabilization. And we also have a time lapse, 10 this one, 20x, so that is fine. And mods, we have panorama and this one I'm not going to try it. And what about the night sight? So night sight, a little bit. So okay, we need to try it with the video cam, right? So video camera wide angle, yeah, video camera in wide angle. So does it support oh my god, it's not a wide angle, I think it's normal camera only. What if I just put normal pixel? Yeah, this is the one with the normal camera. And what is the wide angle? Yeah, wide angle is there. And I can just put 4K 30. Yeah, 4K 30. But it has some 4K 13 wide angle camera. And now let me try full HD 60. So yeah, so I actually like this part because yeah, it is shooting it 4K 30, and video quality also not that bad. I would say it's actually good in my opinion. So yeah, that's pretty much about this one. Portrait, we have tested it, and night sight, we'll just check it how it is working. It is fast. Yeah, it's bright. So yeah, most of the things are working fine. What about the front camera? Video. So yeah, all the things are working fine. This is actually looks stable. So the color signs also looks good. So yeah, that's what about this video. It's maybe a bit long, but I'm sorry for that. I just thought to make the process more fine. So yeah, thank you for watching. Code mode.